You know, occasionally as you're working with these spreadsheets and the data link functions, you'll find that just kind of an artifact of the design that when you make changes to some of these inputs here, the arrays that we generate are going to change in ways that you really should be aware of. So let's go through and learn how to recognize that. First of all, I want to make the point that we're generating array results here. You see the little curly brackets up there? The curly brackets is Excel's way of indicating that what you're looking at is an array result. That's why as you move through this, you notice that the function doesn't change, but the numbers do. And you wonder, well, how does that work? Well, it's because you're not really looking at individual results. You're looking at an array. That's what the curly brackets indicate. You see the curly brackets here as well. And with an array like that, if you were to change one of the components of this input, and that change would force a different result, that's not going to automatically resize the array. See, let me demonstrate. If I scroll down, you see this is 255 values. If I scroll all the way down, this goes all the way down to row 261, right? That's how many elements in that array. If I press F2, you can see that that is still there. The array still exists. Now watch what happens if I change this to a different tag name. Sinusoid, that's not nearly as active. Yeah, that got only 16 values. So as I scroll down, I eventually run out of data. But I didn't run out of array. Take a look up at the top. There's still an array there. If I press F2, you can see there is still an array there. And of course, this leads to problems where people start typing, equals now. They start doing things, they say, oh, you can't change that array. You see this all the time, people working with data link. They don't know that these arrays exist. So that's one instance in which you have to be careful. Now, we do have a way of helping with that situation. If you look in the settings option, we have this option here called Display NA for not applicable instead of blanks. So now, let me force this to change again. I have to force it to change after I made that change in settings. So I was at 255. I'll change back now to sinusoid. And now when I scroll down, we do get a little bit of warning that there are values or there are array entries there. It's just that we don't have any value to show at that point. So that's a nice option to keep in mind. That's an option for you. Some people don't like that. Some people would prefer just to see the end results. Let me force this to update again. Yeah, there we go. So I force it to update. Now we don't see those. Now there's an even more worrisome problem. Let me go back to the original size, CDT158. See, this is 255 cells. If I go all the way down to cell 261, we still see the array. 262, no array. So we're good to go there, right? Well, what happens if I were to change this? Instead of going yesterday plus 7 hours, well, let's say today is Thursday. Let's say if we went with Monday plus 7 hours. Now that ends up retrieving 500 values. The problem is, as you might have guessed, the array does not change in size. What we do is we indicate that there is a problem here that you need to address this with this resize to show all. Okay, that indicates that we're not really seeing all the values yet. Now you can solve this problem once you see it by right-clicking on this and choosing the recalculate, and that will force this to resize. Okay. The other thing you can do if you don't like this behavior, some people would prefer the old behavior, although we don't recommend it. There's an option here to disable that resize to show all values message. So you can disable that message if you want. Highly recommend you do not disable that though, because you really do want to know. You know, you want to know when one of your users has changed an input that results in more entries, but the array is not the right size to show it. Now, again, to solve this problem, let me just do this. I'll go ahead and right-click, choose recalculate. As you can see, now that's resized the array so that it's got enough entries. Now let's just make sure we understand when this might affect this sample data. We were just looking at time or compressed data. With sample data, you might see the same effect if you were to change the interval of time, for example. I change it from 10 minutes to 5 minutes. All of a sudden, we're getting data twice as often, but the array did not resize to show all the results. You see, we still end at row 150. That's the same size of the array as when it was 10 minutes. And alternately, if you change one of the inputs and outputs here, or one of the start time or end time here, that may result in a change to the array. So for example, if I went from yesterday plus 7 to yesterday plus 15 hours, that's just yesterday's day shift. Now you'll see a situation in which the array is still the same size, but the data just stops at a certain point. And of course, that can be addressed by choosing this setting right here, display NA.